decided to go from Inskip. It's a little bit cheaper. It is a way shorter ferry ride as well. It's like 10 minutes. $130 for 10 minutes return is a little bit crazy, but they can charge it, so whatever. So we're literally the only car on this barge though, which is insane. And hopefully that means the island is not super busy. And if it's not, that's just a win for us.
Welcome to our first stop. We're in this epic rainforest. It's called Pile Valley.
Yeah, it's got like, it's something like the only place in the world where rainforest can grow out of the sand, like a certain amount of meters above sea level. I wish I had the exact numbers, but I don't.
Really tall.
They're really tall. They're like these really old trees called Satinae trees. And I think they're about like 1,000 years old. Yeah. There's some really big ones around. They are crazy.
And this road in Pile Valley, it's just epic for photos. So
yeah, so we wanted to bring Rocket down here and get some cool shots of her, and it's just been so epic. It's so quiet here as well at the moment, so yeah. It's just us. It's so beautiful here, like it's crazy. I feel like us and a lot of people love it with good reason. It has like this super white sand and super blue water that just like drops off into the darkness, and it's just, I don't know, it's so beautiful. It's like one of those places that you have to see in person to understand how special it is. But we've just been spending the last few hours here and it's been absolutely awesome. The sun is out. We're just living our best lives on Fraser. Living it up. And I reckon I'm gonna go for another swim. Soon you'll have a floaty.
This morning we're at Eli Creek.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just pretty much going to be here all day. We've got the floaties.
Yes.
And we're going to be sorted. Just chill out here, float down the river.
I think we'll just keep Rocket parked up. The river's right at our back door. Came here, had brekkie. Starting to get a little bit busy now, so I think we're going to go down and get in the water with our floaties.
The whole thing with Eli Creek is it just pumps out fresh water, and it pretty much jump in at the top when you float in, and then
it just takes you back down. So we're gonna do that 5 times today.
Five times. Not six?
Maybe six.
So I recommend bringing a book.
Yeah.
Butter tarts.
I was lying on the grass of Sunday morning of last week, indulging in my self-defeat. My mind was thugged, all laced, the buds all twisted.
Morning.
Morning.
How are we?
Oh,
we're good.
Feeling good.
We woke up in a banger spot, so it doesn't get any better than that.
But yeah, we have a tea, have finished a coffee, probably like head up north today, try to get to the very tip of Fraser today, up near the lighthouse, and then we don't know what else we're doing.
Bang.
Streets of your town. Every day I make my way, I walk the streets of your town. And the sun don't look too good today, but the rain is on its way. Watch the butcher as he blunts his knives. This old town fills up with eager wives. Round and round, up and down, through the streets of your town. Every day I make my way
out.
We have changed our plans, so we were going to go to Champagne Pools, but we also wanted to go up to Sandy Cape, but we realised Sandy Cape, we need like low tide to get there, otherwise it's impossible. So we're going to strap to Sandy Cape, stay near the lighthouse, stay there for the night, come back down tomorrow at low tide, and then go to Champagne Pools.
Welcome to Champagne Pools.
We were meant to come down here yesterday. We've come here today instead because the weather was meant to be really good. The weather's not fab, but the water still looks really beautiful and blue. So we thought we'd still come down. The sun is like trying its hardest to peek through the clouds as well. So fingers crossed we will get some sunshine.
At least the water's very calm. Like normally down here, the high tide, the waves are crashing over the top and it can get pretty rough.
Yeah.
But well, I think that's where it gets its name from. It's like, it gets a real bubbly and...
Fizzles. Like champagne.
Mm.
Yeah. But we're not about that. We like a calm rock pool, so we're here at low tide. Tip for anyone. High tide if you want champagne bubbles. Low tide if you want a nice, calm experience.
Yeah, get that like crystal clear blue water.
That I would stay, stay for you. What would you go do with me? Could I give you what they gave?
Alright, so we are on our way west. We hadn't made up our minds whether we were going to go over this way or not. Some of the camping was fully booked out, which is a little bit annoying, but we've decided we can go stay at Wiraley Creek instead. So we're just heading over there now. We're on some of the sandy tracks. In the center of the island.
Some of the bouncy tracks.
Bouncy bit. Whoa! But they're fun. But we've only got about 20k's to go to get to the other side, but because of the tracks, it can, like, it might take up to an hour, which is fine, because it's just a really nice arvo. And yeah, so we're just on our way now. Hopefully we will be there soon.
Yeah, coming to you live from the hammocks on the western side of Fraser, where the sand is whitest and the water is bluest. And also, fun fact, it's the oldest side of the island. Us for the west side.
Yeah, beautiful spot. We wish we stayed a little bit longer or had more time to stay because it is so beautiful over here. The water's just epic. It's just, I don't know, there's just a different vibe. It's very quiet over here.
Like, I reckon this side is more of like just the camping for a few days, not really going anywhere, chilling out. The water's a lot calmer, you can swim. Mm.
It's just beautiful.
It's just
it's
really
more like
vibe.
Camping vibes. I feel like the eastern side's very touristy and there's like lots to see and do and a lot of people around. You're not getting any tour buses on this side. That's the bonus, I think. But yeah, we're going to jump back in the Troopy and head back over to the east now and then home. So our last stop tomorrow is... It's a surprise.
Lake Wobby. It's a pretty cool lake. Some sand dunes going straight into the lake. So, looks cool.
So I got some info off the board. The lake is the deepest lake on Fraser. So it's like 11 meters deep. So like 12 fishies living in there. Not 12 fish, but 12 species. And that sand dune behind us grows like a meter every year, which means in our lifetime, that lake's going to be goners.
Gone. So make sure you come see it.
Yeah, quick. Because it's happening right now.
It's disappearing as we speak.
Yeah, like beneath our eyes. Is that the saying? In front of our eyes.
Beneath.
So quick. So yeah, we're going to head down there. A little bit of a short walk to get down there. Apparently a bit of a leg burner. But we're here for that. I'm obviously dressed for the occasion. Luke's got his shirt on. We wanted to be dressed for our last spot on Fraser Island. Anyway, let's go there.
Well, if I left, then it made no sense. And you tell your friends, and they hold your hands.